Praise God. I need to write that on my mirror. Set it in my portfolio. Write it on my resume. Amen. I'm just blessed. Amen. We thank God for Jesus for each and every one of you. We thank God, amen, for this Holy Spirit, amen, that's been making a difference in your lives, amen. I'm so encouraged by the testimonies, amen, that has gone forth, amen. And I hope that you are too, because it lets us all know that God is able, amen. It lets us know God is still on the throne, amen. I thank God for Jesus, that despite what you're going through, God is still God. He is the Lord of lords and the King of kings. He is more than able, amen, to present me faultless despite what I'm going through, despite what I'm tripping over, amen. He is able to bring me forth, amen. All I got to do, amen, is disbelieve. How many of you just holding on to your belief, amen? I'm just believing God today, amen. I'm holding on to my faith, hallelujah. And thank God for Jesus. Let's go into the Word of God. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to go to the Word of God in Romans 4. Thank you. Amen. Romans 4. Amen. Praise God.
That I may see.
Amen. I thank God for you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ooh, I can see. Amen. Romans 4, amen. We're going to start at the 17th verse. We're going to kind of eavesdrop in a conversation, amen, that is being relived, amen, by the Apostle Paul, amen, praise God, concerning the great patriarch, amen, Abraham. The word God declares, amen, starting at that 17th verse, as it is written, God told Abraham, I have made thee a father of many nations. Before him whom he believed, even God who quickened the dead and calleth those things which be not as though they were. 18 says, who against hope believed in hope that he might become, that God said, the father of many nations, according to that which was spoken, so shall thy seed be. Somebody say, so shall thy seed be in me. So shall it be. Amen. Thank God for Jesus. Lord, continue to bless your people, Lord God. Continue, Lord God, to saturate us with your love and kindness as we are blessed by the word of God. In Jesus' name. You may have your seats. Amen. I'm so grateful to God, amen, because the word of the Lord declares, amen, as a man of God is sharing, amen, praise God, he's sharing with the Romans, he's sharing with you, and he's sharing with me, amen, but he's letting us know, praise God, that here it is, amen, that Abraham, he was all this salt, as people say, amen, here it is, amen, he said, God spoke a word. How many of you remember back when God spoke that word? Remember reading, of course. Remember reading back, amen, praise God. But when God was setting the stage, amen, to bless his Israel people, amen. When God was setting the stage, amen, don't you remember that he called a man named Abraham? He told him to get on up from amongst your kindred. And he said, go on into a land that I will send you. How many remember that, amen? I want somebody to know, amen, praise God, when God is setting you up for your greatness, amen, sometimes he got to call you out from amongst them, amen. How many of you know, realize, and understand that my life is in God's hand? Abraham had to know, amen, that I know my daddy, but God said go. I know my brethren, but God said go. I've gotten used to my servants, but God said go. And the word of God declares that as Abraham went, God went with him. And as God went with him, he began to encourage him with some promises of God to help him keep going. Don't you know that we're all going somewhere? Don't you know there's a greater destiny that awaits you? Don't you know that God has already spoke the plans that he has for you? And they are what? They, I don't hear nobody. They are what? I need you to know that the plans that God has for you, they are not to harm you, but Oh, God said that he'll never leave me, and he'll never forsake me, and I'm just crazy enough to believe it. When I was smoking dope, I was crazy enough to believe that God was still there. When I was riding dirty, amen, I was still crazy enough to believe that God was still there. God never left me, nor will he ever leave you. In my addiction, I would say, God, help me out this. God, help me through this. God, I don't want to do it no more, but I keep running. God, I need you, and I need you to know that God is never late, nor is it too early. I need you to know that he is with you. Oh, he can hear a sinner's prayer. I need you to know today that God is sharpening you, grooming you, and conditioning you for your destiny. How many of you know it? How many of you know I'm being groomed today? How many of you know my tribulations come with purpose? How many of you know that my heartbreaks, they come for a reason? How many of you know, amen, when I'm rebuking the devil, that God's enabling me to go through some stuff, because he's making me to be who he's called me to be. He's grooming me to walk in the walk that he's called. Oh, somebody needs to know today that our God is able. He's able to keep us from falling. He's able to present us faultless. Oh, yes, he is. Oh, yes, he is. Oh, yes, he is. You heard a man of God's testimony. He said, there's no way that I talk like this. There's no way that I walk like this. But he's more than able to change my life. Master Mina began to testify about the goodness of the Lord. She was living on Skid Row, smoking her dope and drinking her drink. The word of God had came forth and it brought her new life. And now she declares, I'm not homeless no more. I'm not on the streets of Skid Row. I'm no longer walking around selling my jewels for beans. I thank God for Jesus. I thank God for Jesus because he's with me. How many of you know he's with you? I don't care what your situation is. God is with you. Abraham had to find out who the true and the living God is. He had to find out. See, some of us think we know him. We know him in the pardon of our sins. We know him because he's a way maker. We know him because he's God. I know him according to my grandmother's testimony. I know him because the neighbor got food on their table. I know him because he gave me life. But somebody got to realize that my life, amen, praise God, was given for purpose. And God is with you if you're walking it out. How about that? He's with you as you're walking it out, because he needs you to know him and the fellowship of his suffering. He needs you to know him in the kingdom of power. He needs you to know him against all hope. He is hope. He needs you to know him when it looks like there's no more ducks to line up, and then he pops up for your good. You need to know him as a keeper when you don't even want to be kept. How God can keep you despite of yourself. You need to know him as a miracle worker. You need to know him. You need to know him. God can do for you what you can't do for yourself. God can do for you that you believe will never come to pass. God can do for you that you can't even envision. The very thing that eyes see, nor have ears heard, God does for you by way of his spirit, by way of his anointing, by way of his power. Somebody tap in to the power. God, I give you my weakness for your strength. Exchange my sadness for your joy. Oh God, I give you my depression, my anxiety, and my sorrow, just for a touch from the master, just for a touch. Oh God, oh, to know him, to know him. I thank God for Jesus, amen. Every day that we walk this darkened life, amen, I'm so grateful that I know him. The word of God declares, amen, that as he was talking to Abraham, he says, who against hope, he believes in hope. The word of God said that he may become the father of many nations. I got to get my mind together to believe that what God said is true. Many times we look at our situation, we look at our circumstances, and the brain begins to speak to our heart, to begin to talk. You say, I receive the word of God, and I'm inspired. I feel the power of God. I feel the movement of God. And then life begins to show up on a daily basis, moment by moment, hour by hour, and the inspiring word is still there, ringing in my ears, but life is showing up. I can't feed my children. They just fired me off my job. My car done broke down. But the inspiring word of the Lord our God begins to remind you, what did I say, son? And what did I say, daughter? And it gives us just enough to take another step. But the eyes begin to speak to the brain, and the brain begins to talk to the heart. My heart becomes weary, and our strength begins to fail. But that inspiring word says, just believe God. Just believe God. I tell you, God is not a man that he can lie. I need you to just believe God. I know your eyes is communicating something to your brain, but I know you to hold on. Hold on. Somebody today, hold on. You tell the enemy, I silence you and not hear you. I silence you and what I see. I'm going to just believe God, because I know my God. He's worthy of all my praise. He's worthy of all my faith. Oh, I'm just going to believe him today. I'm going to walk this thing out. I'm not going to be mindful of the cares of this world. I'm going to create in me a clean heart while keeping to the path that God has given me, because he's creating in me a vessel of honor.
Yes, thank you.
Because I'm creating the greater in you. God, why do I have to suffer so? Because I'm creating the greater in you. Where would the strength of your faith be if it wasn't because of the strength of your demise? Oh, with great power, God came down and he lifted you up out of your circumstance. Great power, he raised you up, and with great power, he set you apart. With great anointing, he made it possible that you may stand and just believe God. Sometimes we gotta realize things that God is trying to change our mindset. While I'm laying on Skid Row, while I'm doing what I want to do, while I'm saying, making my own way, I have created a way about myself. I have created a mindset, and God has to come in and reroute your mindset. He has to come down and tear down some things. He got to tear down some wrongful foundations. He got to tear down some wrongful walls, some things that have come to separate you from your destiny. Now here it is. God says, I'm going to use oh, I know God can snap his finger, but what will I learn and what will I gain? Here it is, God. He lets us know that many are the afflicted of the righteous, but God delivers us from them all. His delivering hand comes down. Not only does he deliver me, but he changed my mindset. He changed the way I see things. He builds his confidence in me. Is in preparation of my destiny. What I'm going through is preparing my strength. What I'm going through is renewing my sight. What I'm going through is creating in me a clean heart. I'm going through with a purpose. Tell your neighbor, I'm going through with a purpose. Oh yeah, I'm going through with a purpose. I'm not going through my hell, my tribulations, my afflictions, my persecutions. I'm not going through this burden for nothing. God is building in me some spiritual muscles that the devil can't take from me. God is building in me a mindset of faith that the enemy cannot tamper with. God is building in me a heart that will believe him against all odds. Somebody say, amen. And we say, man, I see how they stand in God.
Yes.
I see how they believe God.
Right.
I see how they have faith in God. They call out fire from the sky and it happens. And they declare unto God's name that thus and such shall be and it is. I want to be just like them. But we got to remember. I don't just want the external gifting. I don't just want their external knowledge.
All right.
I just don't want their external capabilities. Because God is grooming me internally.
Right.
Yes. To do an external work.
Amen.
Word of God says, amen, with Abraham, who against hope believed in hope, that he might become the father of many nations, according to that which was spoken, so shall his seed be. And being not weak in faith, he considered not his own body now dead. His faith had been established. His faith had been established, tested, and tried. How many of your faith is being tested right now? You're going through so strong that you don't see your way out. Amen. But you know God is able.
Amen.
Abraham's faith had to go through some gunshot wounds. How about that? Abraham's faith had to go through some trials and been pressed upon. And his faith had been challenged to the place where it was real thin, to the place now it says that he considered not the weakness of his own flesh. God said, I'm going to do it. How is that so? How is that so? I'm already an old man. I don't have a single child. 86 years old. How is it, God, that you're going to give me a child? How is it that you're going to make me the father of many nations? The word of God says he didn't even stagger.
All right.
And I promise, he just believed. God is trying to take us somewhere. Despite what I see, I'm believing in God.
Amen.
Despite what I experience, I'm believing in God. Despite what I go through, woman of God in the white, the beautiful girlfriend, God has from the time that I laid eyes on you right now, praise God, I see a situation in your life. I don't know what it is that you get revealed. That's to his knowledge. But there's a situation that has laid heavy on your heart. God said that you're coming out. God said this situation that you're in is about to revive your faith in such a way that miracles are about to be declared. There's a faith that's coming, woman of God. Because I even sense in the spirit, amen, there was a place of your faith, amen, that was so big, amen, that was so huge, amen. Everyone knew you by your faith, amen. But something came in, amen, and it's sitting on your faith. That's not taking it away, but it's sitting on your faith and it's become burdensome. But God says, amen, praise God, that the fight that you're fighting is a good fight for your faith, woman of God. Now, and you're coming out of this, and I need you to know that when you're coming out, you're coming out as pure gold. You're coming out with a renewed faith. You're coming out with a greater faith. You're coming out with the faith of gold. I don't know if this is involving your children, but God says, amen, that all is well. Says keep your eyes on. on me. He said, I'm going to show you some things. God is doing something with your mind's eye. Amen. He's doing something with that inner eye. Amen. That your faith is going to line up. That he's showing you on the inside. But God said that I'm bringing it to the outside. God says that people will see you different, woman of God. They will be amazed. Amen. And God will try to cause you to stumble. They purposely put their foot out for your demise. God said, I got you, woman of God. God said, prayers have not been in vain. Have not been in vain. God says, I hear your prayers, even in the midst of the midnight hour. Even the utterance, amen. Sometimes it's not even a formal prayer, and sometimes you just feel like, but God says, I hear the very utterance of your heart, and he is working on your behalf. You be encouraged, and know that God is on side. I don't care what the situation looks like, woman of God. This message is for you. God says, I don't care what it looks like. You keep stepping because I'm bringing you out to the greater glory. Somebody give God some praise. Not only believe God that he has a child. See, sometimes our faith is limited. God says, I'm not just blessing you with a child for you. He said, I now need to stretch your faith. Because the anointing that I have on your life, this is what we got to remember. The anointing that I have on your life is not just for your own benefit. It's not just for a generational benefit, but it's for a lifetime anointing. See, what was coming forth from Abraham's seed was not just for his glorification to say, I got a son. I got me a shawty. I got me a boy. You know, boys are special. I got me a boy, child. He went from zero to the multitude. God is trying to bring us from zero to the multitude. The anointing that he has on your life, all those that are under the sound of my voice, is an anointing, amen, praise God, is not just to break the bonds for your life, but God wants to do something for your family and for your family's family. God is doing something, amen, generationally, amen. Some of you, amen, are going to be curse breakers, amen, that's you. Some of you are going to be curse breakers, amen. There's some things in your family's life that God is calling you, and he's anointed you, and he's assigned you to turn around in the family, amen. You got a sweet, sweet spirit, amen, praise God. And many times people try to run over you in your family, amen. But God says, amen, I'm using you, amen, to destroy some battle wounds of the past. There's so much hurt in your family, amen. There's so much hurt, amen, not only in your family, but from your family, amen. But there's some things, amen, praise God, that the enemy has come in, and he's brought some misunderstanding, and he's brought some ill feelings, and he's brought some things. But woman of God, you let it go. You let it go. You forgive them just as God forgave you. You let it go. Amen. Praise God. Because God is desiring to use you. The anointing that he has upon your life is going to destroy some things for them upcoming children. There's some grandbabies that's coming up through you. Amen. Praise God. That God is allowing you to destroy some things so that they don't even have to face it. They don't even have to feel it. They don't even have to go through it. But God is using you. And there's some times, amen, that sweet spirit is set aside and the anger comes out. Yeah, am I talking to you? Yeah. There's some times when that sweet spirit kind of sat down. You know how people say, I lay my religion down. There's some things, amen, praise God, where that anger comes and that resentment comes. God said, give it to me. All right. Give it to me, all that hurt. Oh, yes. That's all it's from. That anger, that resentment, all that stuff is just layered from that hurt. God said, give it to me. give it to me. I want to pray for you. I want to pray for you. Because there's generational blessings that God wants to do through you, one of God. And it starts with letting go. It starts with letting go. Amen. Do we have any musicians in the house? Okay, amen. We thank God for Jesus. Amen. If you would stand with me, woman of God.
I need you to know, amen, praise God, that you are a woman of God. You are a woman of God. The enemy comes to try to tell you sometimes that because you did this, because you did that, because you go here, and because you struggle with this, the enemy tries to tell you sometimes that that God's not paying attention to your words and that God is not concerned. But I need you to know, amen, that I hear God speak the word that you are his woman of God. Amen. I need you to know, amen, without a shadow of a doubt, amen, that you are covered in him. Amen. Praise God. You cry out and you have cried out. Amen. You cried out not only for you, not only for yours, but you cried out for your distant family. Amen. And God says that I'm here. Amen. And I need you not to give up faith in your crying out. Amen. And I hear God say, I need you to even forgive yourself for some things. I get up, let it go. Let it go. If I can sing the Frozen song, let it go, I would. Amen. Praise God. I love that song. Amen. But I thank God for Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Because what he's going to do through you, woman of God, I need you to know that your family is at stake. There's always a kinsman redeemer in the family. Always a kinsman redeemer. You may not even be close to them right now. You may not even be close to them right now. But God says that your prayers have been assigned to them. To them. That they may live a profitable life. There's some things that you see that's all going into a dead end. But God says your prayers, your assigned prayers, even for the ones that hurt you the most, even for the ones that ridiculed you the most, even for the ones that have sat in their religiousness and have spoke negativity towards you. Oh my God. God says, amen, that you have not isolated yourself for no reason. But he's come to build you up, woman of God. He's come to establish you. He's come to restore you. And he's come to strengthen you. Because you got a work to do. But don't worry, because he said, I want to first heal you. I want to first heal you. You've been through some grace. But God says that I've never hurt you. And I've never forsaken you. It's the word of the Lord for you. Jesus. May I pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you, Lord God. I declare the glory upon this woman of God. Father God, I remove every sense, Lord God, of bitterness in the name of Jesus. Father God, I declare that she let it go, that it never be another day of hindrance unto her in the name of Jesus. Lord God, that your spirit flow freely. The prayer warrior in her will not be denied in the name of Jesus. It will not be restricted in the name of Jesus. I declare the power of God. Lord, now go into her heart in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And I tear down every layer of bitterness. I tear down every layer of anger. I tear down every hurt in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord God, I speak to the womb as tender as it is, Lord God. And I declare the healing in the name of Jesus. I declare this woman of God shall rise up and live in the name of Jesus. You've been suppressed too long. You've been babysitting this wound. God declares today is your day of healing. Let it go. In the name of Jesus, let it go. I declare a strength today in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Her total healing. In the name of Jesus. Every layer that has hardened around her heart. I declare the name of Jesus that as of this day it starts melting away. Father, in the name of Jesus, that the true woman of God shall stand. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, revive her again. Revive her again. I see a praise on the inside. Revive her again that she may jump and shout unto the glory of God in the name of Jesus.
And every word curse that's been spoken against you, God. Father God, we return it back to the sinner. In Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord God. And we declare your word to overshadow us every day. In Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody give God a
blessing. Come on, give them some prayer. Thank you, Jesus. For the word of God declares, amen, praise God, that we have to, amen, surrender ourselves to a place of wounding in God.
Yes.
And it starts with believing what he said,
yes,
not what I see.
That's it.
Many times, amen, praise God, that we begin to stagger at the promise of God. We begin to doubt God's word. We begin to become faint-hearted, amen. God, can you do it? See, this is the thing. We don't doubt, amen, when he said that he could do it. But as we go through life circumstance, we begin to doubt his ability. We see the situations, and we say, God, are you able to change that heart? God, are you able to turn that? God, are you able to change this circumstance? The word of God declares, amen, praise God, that in the 21st verse, the word of God says, and being fully persuaded, see, he staggered not promise, and he had got to a place of full persuasion, that he had promised he was able, that day God said he promised he'll do, he's able to perform it. If God said it, he's not trying to work it out, it's already done. Somebody better tell yourself, when God said it, though I don't see it yet, done daily. See, that's where my faith comes in. The word of God declares, but for us also, he says, 22, and therefore it was imputed, that means it was credited to Abraham for his righteousness. I need us to realize that my righteousness is my approval of God. Therefore, when I believe God and I walk this thing out, see, there are some promises that God has not manifested into us yet because he's trying to build our faith. Amen. There's some things, amen, praise God. There's some waters, amen, that you can't fish in, amen. You have to wait to a certain season to fish in those waters, amen. I'm not a fisherman, but I've heard that there's certain times and seasons where the fish that you're fishing for comes down the stream. I need somebody to know that God has not brought forth the manifestation of the catch as of yet, because he's trying to build your faith to the place of the high water. I need somebody to know that God is raising your faith to the place of the high water. While you sitting around saying, he ain't did it yet. I don't think he's gonna do it. My situation has got worse. The murmuring and the complaining has opened the door to the destroyer. But God says that when you believe God against all hope, against all odds, against all that you see, he is elevating your faith. He's taking your faith from 1 to 3 to 17 to 22 till it's able to carry the word of promise that he's spoken to you. Some of us cannot bear the weight of his glory. And this is what we begin to doubt. God is trying to not drown you out. He's not trying to burn you down, but he's trying to strengthen you to carry this promise. Because when your faith can carry the promise, he can manifest it. Somebody declare, my faith is going to carry the promise that he gave to me. I'm just professing it out my mouth, but I'm gonna mount up on wings as eagles, and I'll stand and I'll carry this
cross.
Despite what I see, see, I'm waiting for a gift. I'm waiting for God to just do it and just manifest it. And God say, I'm waiting on your faith.
All
right. I'm waiting on you to stop doubting. Stop criticizing.
All right.
Quit picking at it and just carry.
Carry.
Now, if you're in that place, don't feel bad. That's just where you are. Well, I know I've gotten the promises of God, so I got to next that out. No. That's a part of your building process. How many of your babies failed before they got this walking thing down? they reverted back to what they knew, which was crawling.
Yes.
Sometimes they just fell and they just sat there.
Yes.
Amen. To get this walking back.
Yes. Amen.
But eventually they got back up again.
Yes.
See, this is where we are in our faith. God is building us. Alexander said, I had so much fear and so much doubt that I didn't think I could do it, but she carried the promise. She had people like her auntie. She had people like her pastor. She had people like many of you out here in this congregation that encouraged her. So now she's walking out the promise.
Oh,
amen.
Amen.
She's walking out. The promise has been manifested.
Yes.
Because I carried it.
Alright.
I didn't drop it.
Alright,
I just believed.
Yes.
I'm going to carry it. I'm going to believe God. Though I see all kind of stumbling blocks, my feet is getting tired, and my heart is getting weary, but I'm going to carry the promise. I don't know how this thing is going to come about, but I'm just going to carry the promise until my faith lines up.
Amen.
We talked on Wednesday night about time, purpose, and season. God has spoke a purpose. He spoke a promise in your life that shall come to pass when the time of your faith has been elevated for the purpose in a new season.
Yes.
Somebody got to realize that. Because Abraham, it was credited to him to please God by his faith. How is that? Because the word of God says it's impossible to do what? It's impossible to please God without what? Without faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. So therefore, amen, it was accredited to him because of the way he walked. He staggered not at the promise. Because of the way he carried the promise of God. See, just like you tell somebody, hold this. You tell the church, hold this. And before you turn around, amen, where's what I gave you? I don't know.
Yeah.
I think it's over there.
Yeah.
Baby, it's not over there. Oh, well, it must be over there. It ain't over there. Well, somebody stole it. See, we're that baby. When God comes to visit you in due season, and he brings that message board or that preacher to remind you,
yes,
where's the promise I gave you?
Yes.
Oh God, I stopped believing 10 years ago.
My God.
I dropped it.
Jesus.
The devil stole it from me. Pick your promises back up and carry it. That in that due season of time, you'll walk it out.
Yes,
Word of God says, amen. Was that just for Abraham?
No.
Word of God says in 24, but for us also. So therefore, amen, the way we carry God's promises will be accredited to us in ways that please God. Oh, I don't know about you, but I've got to please God. I've got to please God. If I don't please you with this message, if I don't please my husband with the dinner I cook, if I don't please my family, amen, guess what? I've got to please him.
My God.
I've got to please him. I've got to please him. My boss may not be pleased with my word, amen, praise God, and the IRS sure ain't pleased with my taxes, but I've got to please him.
My God. Glory.
God says that he will impute it unto you the way you carry the promise, the way you carry your faith. This is what God says, I see you. And I'm giving you more of the ability to please me. What is that? Faith. I'm going to add to your faith. What does the word God say? We all have been given a what? A measure of faith. But that measure grows as life goes on. Or have you depleted your faith? Ask yourself. Have I depleted my faith? Do I just believe God? Or do I believe it when I see it?
Amen.
Word of God says that wasn't just for Abraham.
Thank you, Father.
So it's for all of us.
Yes.
To whom it shall be imputed, it shall be imputed to us if we believe. If we believe on him, that raised up Jesus our Lord from the dead. Word of God says, who was delivered for our offenses and was raised again for our justification. While I was still sinning, God gave his life.
Yes, thank you.
For me. For you. And then to hang, bleed, suffer on the cross and give us a promise. But I dropped it. Why you drop it? Because I lost the sense of value. We drop our promises that God has given us because we don't see it come to pass. Just like Isaac and Esau, Jacob and Esau. The value began to demise from the promise of his birthright. The value began to lessen because he couldn't see it. He began to despise it. Esau said, I'm hungry. I'm going through a temporary situation. Jacob seized the moment because he saw the value of the promise of the birthright. He said, I give it to you for this. Sometimes the enemy has swindled us for a night of temporary pleasure.
Yes, Lord.
For a moment of temporariness and calls us to drop our promise.
Yes.
Word of God says, 25, who was delivered for our offenses and was raised again for our justification. 5:1 says, therefore, being justified as we are by faith, we have peace with God. Once I became justified, I have a peace. You heard the man of God talking about the peace?
Yes.
He says, I have peace with God, a peace that I never thought I'd have.
Yes.
I have a peace that I never thought I'd attain. I have a peace, amen, that I never thought that I could live with. The word of God says that we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom we also have access. So the word of God lets us know that with this faith that I have, the word of God says not only do I have peace, but now I have access to him. And with this access to him, I know without a shadow of a doubt that I have kingdom on my side. Kingdom power is given unto you. It is credited to you by the way by which you walk in faith. I need somebody to connect the dots today, amen. Because I have got to get to the place of carrying my promises. Because when I carry my promises, it builds my measure of faith. And when my measure of faith is established, the word of God declares, amen, that I have come to a place where I please God. Therefore, I have access to the King. Access to power. See, when I'm low of faith, my faith prayers are very low. But when I have walked and carried out the promises of God, and as they begin to establish into new heights, the word of God tells me that it's imputed to me, it's accredited to me, it is given to me the ability to please God. Because my faith has been built to a measure where I know who I am. watch my smoke. I'm going through. But check that later. Because the end of the story hasn't come. I can boast. I can glory in my tribulations. The word of God declares. Also knowing that the tribulations that you suffer, they're working what? The work is of patience in me. Some of us are being groomed for our glory, for our greatness, because we've been put in some situations that's building our patience.
My God.
Don't you know that this whole arena of faith is established through patience? Patience, saints of God, isn't just I'm going to wait. How you wait. Because see, we're going to wait. Yeah. As long as God gives me an inhale and exhale, what we're going to do? What are we going to do? I can't make God do it. Oh, Lord knows I tried.
Amen. Okay.
I tried to fast him to do it. All I ended up was being hungry. I tried to push him to do it. I'm going to pray 25 times a day.
Yeah.
He's going to do it tomorrow. You just afraid of something. There's some things that God has assigned to our life. That's a sign for the purpose. The tribulation comes to build your patience. Because your patience is where your substance lies. My patience, amen, praise God, is my steadfastness. How I go through the storm. How I go through my persecution. It's not just going through it because I'm going to go through it. Amen. If God don't remove it, what other choice do I have? But it's about enduring until the end. Remember what God said. Blessed is he that endures to the end. My patience, amen, is my faith under trial. My patience, people of God, amen, is not just my weight, but it's what I'm building, my substance that I'm gaining in the weight. And what does the patience build? Word of God declares, amen, praise God, that the tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. See, as I'm going through, amen, as many of you are, you're going through, amen, because God is establishing, amen, praise God, a new place. Because he's creating your systems of belief and faith. Belief and faith has nothing to stand on if your patience is not intact. If your patience is not intact, you just an anxious person waiting for this thing to come to pass. That's not faith. That's not faith. See, the enemy comes to pervert the weight. In the weight, I'm being established. In the weight, I'm building substance. In the weight, I'm gaining experience. In the weight, I'm knowing God at new levels and in new ways. In the weight, amen, gives me opportunity with God that I may know him and see him as he is in my situation. But see, I want to hurry up and get out of the situation. I want to hurry up and wait. So the enemy comes to pervert how I see the way. Therefore, I start using spiritual innuendos to get me through the very process that God assigned for me, that he may impute to me the very thing that I need to please him. Who am I talking to?
My God. Hallelujah.
I want things to go back the way it used to be.
My God.
I want things to go back the way that I dream them or desire to be. I want things to go back, but God is trying to take that anointing that he's laid upon you that is not just for your own good, but the anointing that he has for you is going to move in the realms of generations after you. But all we can see is right here. This is why God has to establish your patience so you can experience some stuff so that you can walk in a greater hope.
Hallelujah.
Great
job. Good work.
We're very carnal people.
Yes.
Now carnality has birthed a carnal mindset. But God is faithful. Today, amen, as the musicians are playing, you've identified, amen, praise God, that My faith is under fire. As the musicians are playing, you have identified that your faith is under fire. See, some of you know that the fire that your faith is under, see, they just need a little man to consult one another. They just fire against you, just fire against you, and it spreads throughout your house, and even depression tries to sit on you, and you laugh and smile because you don't want it to get you down, but the enemy has assigned his fiery darts towards you. But I need you to know one of God. God said,